In this mechanical system, we have a mass, okay? And it has an NR storage element. And you should know that this is equivalent to capacitance in electrical circuit, okay? And it stores kinetic energy. And we have two dampers. Dampers are equivalent to resistance in electrical circuit. For this point of view, they don't store energy. They only dissipate energy. In that respect, since they cannot store any energy or any information, they don't increase the order of the system. For that case, this is a first order dynamic system, since we are only interested in the velocity of the mass. We are not interested in the position. Okay, so what is the input? Input is the velocity of this point. Okay, so we have a damper, and what we do is we push the damper from one side with a velocity of Vi, and it technically affects the other end, which is mass, and dampers resist the motion between two terminals in terms of velocity. They don't resist the position. So the force of the damper is independent of the distance between two terminals. They only technically depend on the velocity difference between Vi and Vm. It's one of the important things about the dampers. Okay, that's great. So let's draw a free body diagram, which is very easy. This is a mass. Okay, so there is no friction coming from the ground, but it is connected. This damper is connected to ground, so it is resist the motion. So this damping resistance affects in this direction. Let's call it F2. Okay, and if I push this damper in this direction, okay, and if I assume that Vi, and this is an assumption just for drawing the free body diagram, we don't need to assume it for a general thing, is greater than Vm, it will compress the damper, and damper will technically push both sides, so we will have a force in this direction. Okay, so we will have a force in this direction. Okay, because this damper is pushing the mass, and the other damping is technically resisting the mass. Okay, so you can think that they are technically acting in different directions. Okay, but the thing is, depending on the Vi and Vm, F1 can has a negative value, which means that it can pull the mass in some instance, because these are dynamic systems. We are not interested in a specific force balance equation at a specific time. We are interested in the dynamic behavior. Okay, so let's try to write the necessary equations using this free body diagram. And if you look at the lecture notes, I used a slightly different formulation to technically solve the same problem. And it's important because you should understand that while solving these kind of mechanical systems, there is not a single way of solving the problem. Okay, but end result is very critical and it should be seen. Okay, good. So what is F1? As I told you, I assume that Vi is greater than Vm. In that respect, F1 is equal to B times V1 Vi minus Vm. And we know that U of T is equal to Vi. This is my input. That's great. So what is F2? F2 is equal to B times Vm. Okay, that's great. That's nice because it's technically compressing the damper. It has a positive force in this direction. So it is, as you can see, B times Vm. So what we need to do is we need to write equations of motion. We know that M times acceleration, which is equal to Vi dot, is equal to, okay, and Vi is assumed to be in this direction. So as you can see, F1 is acting on the same direction. So this is equal to F1 minus F2. That's great. So if I move it here, M times Vi dot is equal to, what is F1? B times Vi minus Vm. That's great. Minus B times Vm. Okay, that's great. So this is not Vi. This should be Vm. That's great. Okay, so let's change Vm with Y because it's our output, and Vi with U. M times Y dot is equal to B times Ux minus Y minus B times Y. That's great. So if I technically reorder it, M Y dot plus 2B times Y is equal to B times U. This is the ordinary differential equation that governs the equations of motion of the system. Okay, let's check my notes. It should be the same. As you can see, it is the same. Okay, even if I draw a slightly different free body diagram, in the lecture note, I assume that technically the direction of the force is in this direction, but in this case I need to change the equation of the force, but I will need to obtain the same result. Okay, so this is the basic idea. As you can see, it's very simple because it's a first order system. So what we can do is we can transfer it into transfer function domain and find the Laplace domain expression. Let's take the Laplace transform of both sides. Okay, m, that's great. What is y dot? It is equal to s times the Laplace transform of y plus 2b y of s is equal to b times u of s y of s ms plus 2b is equal to b times u of s. So if I technically simplify it, transfer function is equal to y of s divided by u of s. It is equal to, okay, s plus 2b divided by m. I'm reorganizing the coefficients. This is equal to b divided by m. Okay, so in transfer function, if it's not mandatory, we generally try to leave the higher order s term in the denominator alone. Okay, so such that we can better understand the like the order, details, the structure of the system. This is more like a preference or convenience, but it's not mandatory. Okay, so this is the transfer function of the system, as you can see, that we obtained from the order and differential equation. Okay, now we will do something else. Okay, so let's also clean everything. Okay, so we compute the transfer function. Now what I'm going to do is I will draw an electrical equivalent of the mechanical circuit, okay, using this equivalence as the analogs between electrical and mechanical circuits. We will do that, and then we will try to solve the electrical circuit such that we will test if we can find the same transfer function from the electrical analogy. Okay, so what is mass? Mass is a capacitor. Okay, so one important thing about mechanical systems in Newton mechanical is it's capacitor, it's true. Okay, so, and as you remember, voltage, okay, so velocity is analogous to voltage, okay, force is analogous to the current. And when we talk about voltage, we can talk about voltage difference or voltage of a point with respect to a reference frame. Okay, so in a mechanical system, reference frame is always ground. So this is ground, okay, inertial reference frame. So technically, we connect this capacitor, which is a mass, with respect to ground reference frame. Okay, so this is assumed to be 0 volts, which means 0 velocity. As you can see, it's very like convenient to stop there. And since this mass has a velocity with respect to the ground, what we call is that this is equal to VI, which is the voltage or velocity of this node. Okay, so if you remember, mass is directly equal to the capacitance value of the capacitor, which is equal to M. Okay, so M is analogous to the capacitance value if you follow the process technically explained in the lecture notes. That's good. So what is damper? Damper is the resistor. This damper is connected between the mass and the ground. So what we do is this: we connect a resistor in this part. Okay, so it is connected to mass and ground, because so what is the velocity here? It is equal to Vm. So what is the velocity? Because it's 0, because it's connected to ground. Okay, so, and if you remember, the resistance value of the resistor is equal to 1 over B. Okay, so check your lecture notes. Okay, so this is different. It is connected to the mass. So this velocity of this point is equal to Vm. So we draw the resistor. Okay, and the other end is connected to the voltage input or velocity input. Since on the analog of a velocity is voltage, what we have is a voltage source. Okay, that's great, right? So now we have a very simple electrical circuit that technically this is not Vm, this is should be Vm, this should be Vi. Okay, so instead of dealing with Vm and Vi, let's change them such that we know that this is equal to Y, this is our output. Y is the voltage or velocity at this node, and Vi is the input, so it is equal to U. Okay, as you can see, it's very convenient. Now we have an electrical circuit which we obtained by transforming the elements in an electrical domain. Okay, so if I find a transfer function between y of t and u of t in this electrical circuit, is it going to be the same? This is the important question. So what are we going to do is we will apply KCL for this simple electrical circuit. So we have a current in this direction, okay? And we have a current in this direction, which is the capacitor current, and we have a current in this direction. Okay, so in the KCL, what we should technically that, due to the continuum principle, this current should be equal to the sum of these currents. Okay, so what is this current? This current is very simple. U, this is the voltage at this point, minus Y divided by, and since this is also B, the resistance is equal to 1 over B, 1 over B is equal to the current in this direction. Okay, what is the current of the capacitor? If you remember, it is equal to C times dVc over dt, V dot, which is equal to M times Y dot. M times Y dot plus, what is the current here? The voltage Y, voltage 0, Y divided 1 over B. That's great. Okay. So, if I order everything, I will obtain that, okay, B times U is equal to M times Y dot plus 2B times Y. If you remember, this is the exact the same ordinary differential equation that we obtained when we directly modeled the mechanics. Now we modeled the electrical equivalent, and without no surprise, we obtained the same result. If we find the transfer function, as you can see, we will obtain the same result, B divided by M, S plus 2B divided by M.